And Daniel Andrews has taken an extraordinary swing at the Reserve Bank. The Premier isn't convinced it's fixing inflation, arguing 11 rate rises in a year is smashing families. State political reporter Mark Santomartino.
Staring down the barrel of a $165 billion debt, Daniel Andrews, like many Victorians, can't afford interest rates to climb any higher.
I'm not sure that 11 interest rate rises in 12 months is smashing inflation. I'm certain it's smashing families.
And the Premier went so far as to say the Reserve Bank of Australia is getting it wrong.
They're pulling this lever, and I don't know that it's necessarily effective against the problem they're trying to solve. They borrowed in good faith with the expectation from no less an authority than the Reserve Bank that interest rates would not be going up.
The state government also borrowed big. Pre-pandemic, Victoria's net debt was predicted to be $57 billion in 2023. It's currently $104 billion and costing taxpayers more than $10 million a day in interest.
What the Premier needs to do is to stop shirking responsibility. He needs to front up and take responsibility for the horror budget that he and his government are about to impose upon every Victorian.
The next state budget will be handed down on the 23rd of May. Daniel Andrews has forecast tough decisions, but repeatedly dodged questions about what could be cut and further cost of living relief, insisting the country needs a national plan to tackle Australia's housing crisis.
I'd be very grateful to the Reserve Bank if they could help persuade the federal government that we need a national housing plan. I think that'd be fantastic.
Waste is in the DNA of this Andrews government. More than $30 billion overspent on major projects.
Mark Santomartino, Nine News.